Advances in Health, I'm Rebecca Stewart. Summertime, most of us love the warmer temps, but we are reminding you today to drink more, and not just because of dehydration. Dr. Josh Stein joins us now, a urologist at the Hospital of Central Connecticut. Thank you.
Hi.
And today we are talking about kidney stones, which are more common in summer. Tell us why.
Yeah, well, what happens is that a lot of individuals may get dehydrated because they're losing a lot of fluid through sweat. And it's important to remember that in the summer months, if we're sweating because of the heat, we actually have to drink a lot more fluid to remain hydrated. And what I think of it as is that if you imagine a cup of water and you pour salt into it, if you put enough salt into it, eventually it's going to start to come out and precipitate, if you will, at the bottom. Sure. And the same thing can happen in the kidneys. If there are electrolytes in the kidneys and there's not enough fluid, eventually that'll start to precipitate, and that's what causes kidney stones.
And take us through, what are kidney stones exactly?
Well, kidney stones are rocks, if you will, that actually form in that environment in the kidney. And usually if they're sitting in the kidney, they don't usually cause any problem, but it's only when they break free and they're free to fall down and get stuck in the ureter tube that drains the kidney out down to the bladder that they cause problems.
And that's when people have tremendous pain, the symptoms. Yeah. What do they typically feel?
Well, the most common symptoms would be pain in the back or side, and sometimes nausea, vomiting, fevers, chills, and occasionally blood in the urine.
And how important is it at this point that you make sure to get somewhere that's going to help you?
Well, certainly if you feel that kind of pain, particularly with a fever, it's important to get in to get evaluated. It's really important at that point that we can assess where the stone is, the location, the size, and try to figure out the likelihood that it may pass on its own.
So your best advice, drink lots of water throughout the summer months. Dr. Josh Stein with the Hospital of Central Connecticut. If you'd like to learn more, head to WTNH.com/advances in health.